setup. Table's like got a sink and a couple cubbies. And then why that shock thing isn't hooked up, I don't know. I'll have to look into that. But anywho, I had the guy I bought it from didn't have it licensed with DMV. Let me put this down, it's heavy. Didn't have it licensed with DMV, so I ended up having to go to the highway patrol. This thing won't sit straight. I'm sorry. Anyway, I don't know. That's it. Put you down. But I'm trying to set this bed this way so it can all air out. Anyway, so I took it to DMV and they said that because it never had a license plate on it before, it wasn't registered, that I'd have to take it to the sheriff's department, they'd have to do a search on it, yada, yada, yada. And the guy said, the guy that I bought it from had told me that since it was as small as it is, that, sorry, it wasn't a requirement. Well, now I got myself in a pickle. What did I do? I don't know. Anyway, let me finish this story. So, the guy said that because it was so small, it didn't need to be registered, licensed, blah, blah, blah. Well, last thing I want to do is get pulled over and all that crap. So I went ahead and went to the highway patrol office in Atwater, told them my story. I got to sit down. And they took all the information off of the tiny trailer. And I guess they do some sort of a search on the VIN number. I'm not real sure. Anyway, they called me back and said, okay, everything checks out. It's not stolen, blah, blah, blah. So I went back. He gave me some paperwork. Then, of course, I had to go wait at DMV for ever. And it was, they gave me permanent trailer plates. And it was like $174. And I guess every 10 years, 5 years, I have to pay, I don't remember how much it was. But at least I've got plates. So now I got to figure out how to hook those plates on because it's got a bumper. But if I put the license plate on the bumper, it covers up half of the taillights, you know, on the left and on the right, if I center it on there. So I don't know. We'll figure it out. Not quite sure what I want to do on that thing yet. I do have a little portable stove. What I'm going to do is I'm going to set the bed of my truck up with some kind of a drawer that pulls out of the truck and has a leg that comes down, so it's a flat drawer that extends out of the bed of the truck. And I'm going to set that up as my kitchen. And then, not sure if I'm going to take my generator. Seems like a little overkill. Because I've got my jackery and I've got the solar panels for the jackery. Don't really want to take the generator. It's pretty heavy for me to lug around. But anyway, that's the scoop on that. So I'll set my little kitchen area up in the bed of the truck. And I've got a little, I think it's a butane stove. I thought I had a little propane Coleman, but I haven't been able to locate it yet. And then my cast irons, plates, forks, cooking utensils, bowls. Those will all be in a drawer in the little pull-out thing that I do. And then as far as in that cubby in the tiny ravine, I think in there I'll just put my like emergency equipment, a tow rope, stuff that I won't need every time I pull over somewhere, but stuff that's just good to have. Anyway, that's kind of the scoop. So for today, on the rest of this tiny trailer, the mattress is stuck in one of the folds, so I gotta open it up, fix that. And then I've got some canvas restore water resistant waterproofing stuff. I did a video on it before. I think I want to do that again, probably just on the outside. And then I gotta find out where to get some screen. I want to redo those two screens. I think the door screens are okay. I see my chickens. Anyway, so I was saying, losing my mind, that 2 years ago, I guess it was 2 years, maybe a little longer now, that we were told to shelter in place or whatever that was called. Yeah, I just kind of, there was nothing going on. I wasn't traveling. And I had a couple of medical issues that prevented me from doing much of anything. Nothing major. I was in the hospital for it once before. Blah, blah, blah. So there just wasn't a lot going on. So that's why I didn't video anything, really. I mean, I put out one or two. But so, I'm glad you're back. I'm glad to be back. I've been talking with a girl I've known for quite a while, Texan. That's her YouTube channel. Right now she's in PA. My chicken's limping. She's got bumblefoot and bandages. But anyway, she's in PA. And she's got a van. Her name's Texan. She's got a YouTube channel. Anyway, I'm supposed to meet up with her. We've kind of been talking, texting back and forth. She said something about wanting to go to Arizona. I was there the end of October. Was it 2 years ago? I was there with Randy, mobile traveler. And a bunch of other people. And even in the beginning of November, we stayed through Thanksgiving. And I think we left the day after Thanksgiving. And it was hot and windy and dusty. So I'm not thrilled about going back there, but to meet up with Texan, I will. Hey, girl. And I figure if it gets too windy, I've got some really good stakes. Just stake this tiny RV down. If it gets too windy, I can sleep in the back of my truck because it's got the back seat folds this way so that you have, like, this is your backrest and this is a seat, but it folds this way and makes into almost a twin size bed. So if I get too uncomfortable, I can always sleep in the truck. Oh, and I don't think I've told you guys this. I've been making, I guess they're called MREs, meals ready to eat, but I put them in my canning jars. Last time I went to Arizona, I took a bunch of canned food. I took chicken and mushrooms and spaghetti sauce and you name it, I had it canned and I had it in the truck. But the glass jars were an issue. None broke. But the weight, you know, of all that liquid from canning the food was worrisome to me. So I've been freeze drying my own food and putting them in my glass jars. The reason I do the glass jars instead of the Mylar bags is because the Mylar bags, for some reason, don't seem to hold their seal. And once
oxygen gets in those mylar bags, hits that moisture, and the food starts to soften up. So I'll just stick with my canning jars, and I use the seal-a-meal and an oxygen absorber in them, and they seal up just fine. I've done cheese, I've done eggs, I've done milk, I've done meat, I've done pork, carrots, candy, all kinds of stuff. So yeah, I'll just take, and then that freeze-drying it, that reduces the weight to almost zero. You know, the heaviest part of it's going to be the jars. And then to reconstitute, you just put a little water back in it, and it's great. The powdered eggs, the freeze-dried eggs that I do, it's 1 tablespoon of the egg powder to 1 tablespoon of water. Mix it up, and you have scrambled eggs, or you put it in a cake mix, or waffles, or whatever. And you can't taste the difference. Anyway, all right. I think I've rested and talked enough. Now I got stuff to do on that tiny trailer. I've got a portable potty. I've got a shower system, shower tent all set up. Well, not set up, but ready. For the shower, I'm just going to use, it's a bottle. It has and you spray. That's going to be the shower. The portable potty chair thing, or whatever it's called, is the, you put, I want to say peat moss, but I don't think that's it. Anyway, so that's taken care of because of, I mean, you got to have it and you got to go. And I think that's about it for today. Looking at my neighbor over there. Okay, so that's it for today, guys. Sorry I've been gone for so long. Just nothing going on in my life that was worth recording or telling anybody about. Anyway, I'll be back tomorrow or the next day with another video. Hopefully I'll have a little more progress. And I'm going to search for that screen for this thing. Anyway, I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching. Bye.